Alright, I've got the recording started. Hopefully that doesn't make it all upset. But yeah, let me know what the stream looks like with the 60 frames per second. Oh, I swear I saw her over here? That's weird. I love how this looks. Oh man, I missed that. I missed that one. It's like right next to that rift. Getting around in here is a pain in the butt. Ooh. Oh good, you got an email saying that I'm back online. That's good, so that's working. And Kayuk has 4 dragons left to kill. That's amazing. I'm actually avoiding familial obligations. You guys are a fantastic excuse to not go out to dinner with the extended family. So thank you for that. I mean, I love them to death, really, but I just don't really feel like it right now. I probably would be like, I don't want to go anyways, but... Oh, you got the skin that blank. Nice schematics. Wow. So yeah, you could get that at like the beginning of the game now. Wow, that's really cool, Ashley. I did want to say... something... Hang on, I will say something in a second. I'm making fantastic excuses to not go outside. No, wait. No, wrong button again. Okay, I wanted to say thank you. There've been a couple of people who donated lately, and I just, it didn't even show up. I guess it was actually a while ago, but I noticed it because I was trying to do like Twitch thing, or like I was trying to do the Twitch alerts thing, and I went on there, and I noticed. I'm pretty sure somebody, so at least, okay. I just want to check. Why is Cassandra so... Oh my gosh, Cassandra! She's right in the screen. Holy crap. Alright, I believe this was Frog Raider. But Frog Raider donated. And I really appreciate it. I'm pretty sure it's Frog Raider. It's a different name. But I'm pretty sure it is. But thank you very much. It said that you... donated, I'm pretty sure it looks like today. And I appreciate that. She's waiting to start because Andrew's like, freaking hurry up. So I don't know. I wish I had Twitch alerts that worked. I didn't realize you needed like a bad A computer to make Twitch alerts work for whatever reason. But thank you. I appreciate that, and I'd like to acknowledge the people who do that. And I'd like to try to acknowledge followers more. We have like almost, we have 48 followers? And that's insane to me. And I wish I had like a follower notification too, but I try to, whenever I see the emails on stream, I try to say thank you. So, just if you want me to follow, then unfollow, then follow, and I'll hopefully see the email, and I'll hopefully be able to say, hey, thank you. Oh man, Larry, yeah, you're right. Freaking Cassandra's like, let's start already, you idiot. And then, oh no, Larry. Larry's like, no one's talking about her butt. Yep. Cassandra loves it when people talk about her butt. I'm excited to make, like, this male rogue guy. He's gonna be, like, a daggers guy. And he's gonna totally flirt with everybody. And then he's gonna, like, slowly fall for Cassandra. She's gonna fall for him. It's gonna be super uber romantic. It's gonna be great. Let's try to get out of this hellhole. I actually really like this place. The swamp, it's pretty cool. Swamp cool, Stotten. Cool, Stotten. Let's go do things. Come on, this is not even that hard. I don't even know. Trying to get up and in and out and around and out of here is weird. Oh, maybe this is more like Tevintery stuff? I don't know. I did watch the clip! I did! I spent the whole time trying to make Twitch alerts work, and I also watched that clip, and it was freaking hilarious. And the guy, whoever it was, chose the exact answer I would have chosen. What am I doing? Quest map. Quest map. I was gonna maybe run back for that camping spot, but I'm not. Not. Does the 60 frames a second look okay? Does it look any better than like the 30 frames? Or does it look worse? Or does it look the same? Ooh, oh yeah, there's the little fishing village. Alright, we're like well on the way. I love this place. It's totally reminded me of Skyrim. I was like, Skyrim, 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 Skyrim. Ah, it's like a 10 frames a second bird just ran right through me. Yo. Yo. Oh, there's like another one person back there. Hi, you're totally chill with me just walking in. Hello. Ooh, this is my first time seeing it on the PC. Why is there a person standing completely vertically, like, at a weird angle that they wouldn't be standing at? Always pick up strange stories and look at all these in books. Aye, it is natural. It's good for learning how to read.
What is that commotion?
What is that commotion? Honestly, can't tell. Okay, I won't worry about it then.
Your climbers seem tired, thanks. Or hunting. Is your hold beast well?
Oh, you
we
jerk!
Hunt as well as ever, Thane Harrison.
You would be safer under the shield of the Jaws of Hakkon.
Ask Fisherson has taken victory in sight of the Lady of the Skies. Parv, you owe 4 rams to Hask, not 3.
Teared his tits.
Wind, lift your oaths to the Lady of the Skies and hand the rams over come sunrise.
May your people be as strong as your hold.
He's a jerk! I didn't ever realize. Imagine having to fight them all. It would be a glorious battle. It would. These guys are great. I love them. I would love to be an Avvar, like, hardcore.
We've heard of your arrival, though. Come,
holy crap, look at that maul she has! Jeez!
Inquisitor, I am Svara Sunhair, Thane of Stonebear Hold.
Thane of Stonebear
Hold. You have guest welcome here. The Lowlanders have little love for your Dalish clans. I am impressed to lead their
Thank
Inquisitor.
You!
You and your people have come far from the safety of the Lowlands.
We noticed.
We have not come to cause trouble in your home, Thane. We have learned that the last Inquisitor may have died here hundreds of years ago. We seek his body.
Giving peace to the dead is a worthy quest.
Yeah.
Any help we can offer is yours.
Sadly, she's all forearm strength.
Hakkon will not offer so warm
yeah,
a welcome.
She's ripped.
You have met their Thane, Gerd Harrifson.
Yeah, but I didn't.
I wager you have crossed.
I didn't actually meet him. I didn't talk to him.
If you would search this place for your Inquisitor's body, they will want you to pay in blood.
You know nothing, Jon Snow.
When I first entered your hold, there was a climbing contest of some sort. What was that?
The test of the
I want to get a close-up, not on... This is the perfect shot of Cassandra, though. Trying to get a close-up on Thane Sunair, but I can't.
For the test of the Mountain Father, you battle with Verse while those who favor you hold you aloft. The test of Hakkon is battle with blunted weapons.
It seems as fair a way as any to decide such matters.
In many cases, the law is clear. The tests are only for real disputes. As Thane, I may guide the gods in finding who is worthy. I decide which test will settle the dispute.
I love her! She's so cool!
I may also ask a warrior whose claim is foolish to climb with stones strapped to his back.
I'd like to know more about the Jaws of Hakkon.
They are not the first hold to take that name. All have been foolish. What would you know of them?
What do the Jaws of Hakkon believe that makes them so angry?
A wise man honors each god.
Oh, my time, Cassandra doesn't look mad as when you kiss
your
her.
Your reed beard for fishing. Rilla it's of the far side for making babies. The Hakkonites care only for Hakkon Winter's Breath, god of war and winter. There is no evil in Hakkon. There are times to fight, but the Jaws of Hakkon care for nothing else. They raid, they fight. Eventually they die and their stories are forgotten. It is the way of things.
Interesting.
You said that there were earlier groups known
as
the
Jaws
of Hakkon.
Is there a pie in that little...
Yes. Many ages
There's
ago.
Cheese in there! There's cheese!
But slaughter
Lemonsy, where are
they
you?
The
There's cheese in there!
Your people fought back and destroyed them. They were fools.
You've never fully watched Jaws of Hakkon DLC? It's freaking great. It's my favorite.
What can you tell me of the people now calling themselves the Jaws of Hakkon?
They came here a few years ago, after the Blight took their hold. There was land enough for both, so we were friendly. We did not see their anger. Gerd Harrifson lost too many in his hold to Darkspawn. He thought only of battle.
He's not a bad man.
To avenge a wrong is a good thing, but only a fool lights the world on fire.
Solas, are you listening? Are you listening, Solas? Holy crap! Can we brand that on Solas's head? Like, his shiny bald head? Because he started this whole thing because the Evanuris were like jerks, and plus, basically, they killed Mythal. Like, and he considered that unforgivable. But only a fool lights the world on fire, Solas! Oh my gosh.
I'll speak with you later.
Farewell.
Cheese is taking over the land. Cheese is always taking over the land.
Inquisitor.
Tell me of your hold.
I'd like to hear more about Stonebear Hold.
We are not the largest hold, but our warriors are strong, and our singers are pretty.
Ah,
words are for boasting around the fireside. You should look yourself, if you will.
At the pretty ladies? Alright, one sec, guys. Bugman came back and is holding the kids hostage. Dog or kids? You said dog? It was family. It was definitely, the Bugman definitely came back and held the kids hostage. Just very casually. He's like, so yo, I got the kids hostage. And I'm like, so yo, how about you give them back? My parents will be back soon, and I don't want to have to negotiate while they're here. Oh yeah, they're getting ready to go out to dinner. She wanted to show me her pretty dress. Sunhair.
How did you get the name Sunhair?
You can't even see her hair, which is sad. She looks kind of bald under there, to be awesome.
I once fought a battle with my hair on fire.
You lit your hair on
fire. Maybe that's the point.
An enemy archer lit my hair on fire. I was locked shield to shield with a foe, and I had no time to douse it. It scared my foes. My hair was braided long enough that I could spare it. It stank worse than goat shit, though.
Burnt hair smells very, very bad. I wonder if she is actually bald. Like, her hair got all burned off. You know? And it's Svara's sun hair because she used to have hair that was on fire, but now she doesn't have any hair. Did the Mimbari get cured from the Blight in Dragon Age? Okay! You know what's so funny? Okay, but Kai, no. I had the same thought just earlier today or yesterday. I can't remember. But I was trying to remember the name of that flower that they used to cure your Mabari in Origins. Because I was like, why hasn't nobody used this to maybe cure humans? And what, like, maybe it can't cure humans. Well, then freaking why? Like, and how can it cure a dog of the blight? Like, that is so funny that you bring that out, because that was actually something, that and the Canary thing was something I wanted to bring up, to be like throwing out there, to be like, does anybody know anything about this? So if anybody has any specifics about the Mabari thing, like, please let me know, because for some reason that popped into my head earlier. Ashley, the homecoming is coming and nobody's asked you. You're very upset. I don't blame you. I don't know. I actually went with friends usually, or didn't. Just a couple, like, girlfriends. Like, I was like, if I'm not gonna get asked, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna wear a pretty dress. And my friends and I, none of us got asked to homecoming. Or, like, it was prom, actually. Our senior prom or something. We didn't get asked, which was fine by me. But, we decided we were gonna dress up in pretty dresses, get all done up, and we went to a fancy restaurant and ate, and then we went to the dance, and then we stayed for, like, an hour, got bored, left and went to our friend's house where they had a pajama party going on, and we just put our onesies on and hung out the rest of the evening. It was great. I mean, yeah, Seshu, you totally, like, if you can cure them with a flower, but that's actually, like, that's incredibly interesting. Like, if you, I mean, like, Kaiyuk, unless you're wondering if you've never cured the dragon, have you played Origins? Because if you have, and you haven't cured the Mabari, yeah, there's a quest to do it, to get it, to cure it. But I think it's really interesting that there's a quest to cure the Mabari of the Blight when the Blight's supposed to be incurable. Heck yeah, Ashley, go ask him yourself, too. If, like, three people want to hang out or want to ask you. Man, high school is tough. Freaking high school is just, man, once you get out of high school, the world just opens up. Like, I know people say that, but, man. Definitely go ask the cutest one, the one you like, the one that you like the most.
The Hakkonites
of the three that you think might ask you.
I would welcome any assistance you could offer.
Bathing my blade in the blood of the Hakkonites would be cause for a feast for most in this hold. The Hakkonites are fools. And they have forgotten the old ways. But we have pledged peace with them. To attack with lowlanders at our side would make us oathbreakers. This is poor weather for me to ask that of my hold.
Ah.
What would change the weather?
Good question.
A hold draws strength from its
hold. Oh, yeah.
They are as kin to us. When our hold beast is strong and happy, there is joy. When it sickens and dies, it is an ill omen. Our bear,
Storvaka,
has not been seen in days.
Well, I mean, normally it is the guy that asks, and then are you gonna have a Sadie Hawkins dance afterwards? Storvaka returns. Kaiyuk, I know, right? So if you know about the cure, then why are you not looking for those flowers? Yeah, like, what's up with these flowers? Like, have we not studied these flowers all the way? Like, did we just go, oh, it was just a vague idea? And I think it actually mentions in one of the books, Last Flight, I think, which I just finished reading recently, that somebody gets, like, blight sick or something, and a griffin gets blight sick, and they're like, there's those legends of those flowers, you know, in Ferelden, but it's too far away, and if that was true, then we would have researched it, and all those flowers would be gone by now, because people would be using them, you know? You might have it. So they don't have it planned out. One of my old high schools, I went to two different high schools, they, like, had a dance every month, and they were planned out from the beginning of the year. It was ridiculous. Yeah, I know, Larry. You'd like to think you have people looking for those flowers and it's just not talked about. And says she, yeah, you don't think, and I hadn't really thought about it until like earlier today or yesterday. I can't remember, but it was very recently. I was like, what? Well, Ashley, I still think you should go ask somebody if you like them. If you think it'd be fun, you can go as like, be like, hey, you want to go with me? Make it casual. But I know that that's really hard. That's really hard to do. I'm a major introvert, and I don't really have an interest in that sort of a thing. I enjoy just going with my friends and going somewhere nice to eat. And then dressing up and looking pretty, wandering around for a bit, and then going and back and hanging out and watching TV in a onesie. It was the best. You just don't pay attention. Ooh, Kaiyuk, you're thinking about your hero Ferelden, and where's he at right now? If your hero Ferelden's still alive, you should have gotten a war table mission. If you have a world state that has your hero. And basically what that letter says, no matter who they are, who they've romanced, what they've done, basically they're spending spending their time exclusively trying to look for a cure for the blight. So I wonder if they are actually looking for those flowers. Or something. You know, like maybe they're checking the flowers out as a source. Kaiyuki never did the dances. Yeah. I would go to like the fun, casual ones usually, but I never really went to the ones where you had to ask people or... Whoa. So about me and bears.
I'm a little confused about why I have to find a bear in order to gain the support of your tribe.
Storvaka is not a bear. She is our hold beast. She ties us to the gods. Without her, we... I have heard your elf gods turned from
you. Ah.
Is that not a bad thing? It is as that. I know more of
interesting.
World of spirits. Speak with our augur if you would know more. They're our gods, not yours. For you, it is enough that Storvaka matters to us.
Mm-hmm.
You have members of the Hold searching for Storvaka.
Get to look up a Sadie Hawkins dance? High school, U.S. high schools are up. Yeah, the Sadie Hawkins is where the girls ask the boys.
If she were dead, the Augur would know. So the hunters watch for tracks. That is all we can do.
Yeah, they make it very complicated here.
Does Storvaka usually live in the Hold?
Oh, the Dalish. Talon says Storvaka like they say it. Yeah.
Pens are for goats and chickens, not hold kin. The Avvar are free. So must be our hold beasts. Storvaka lives in a cave near the hold. She comes to visit if she wishes to see us. We bring her gifts of food. Not enough that she will not hunt for herself.
Exactly.
The way you asked us to help find Storvaka made it sound like you were willing to break your oath.
I could say that Avvar hold all oaths sacred, that no true Avvar would break them. It would be a good lie.
I like Thane Sunhair.
The same with themselves. A cunning Thane can find a hole in the tent of any promise. A place for the cold winds.
It's like legit. It's not just like, oh, we're all about honor. They are all about honor.
Until they are broken.
But. Yeah, exactly. Like, oaths last until they're broke. It's just how it is.
Bear, would you break the oath? What happens to Stonebear Hold?
Other holds share oaths with the Jaws of Hakkon. They are sworn to defend or avenge them. If the Hakkonites were friends, they would attack us. But they are friends to few. We will send offerings, trade, and gifts to pay the price of oath-breaking. The storm will pass. I do not do this lightly,
right.
Inquisitor. But the Hakkonites...
Well, it looks like her hold is the one bearing the brunt of the Hakkonites, you know?
Maybe I shouldn't bring this up, but bears and I traditionally do not get along.
Bears and I traditionally do not get along.
Good for you. Fear will keep you respectful should you find Storvaka. You will be fine.
Talon!
So you're saying she's friendly?
No.
I'll speak with you later.
Are the...
those in the hold about Storvaka.
All right.
They may know something they have not told me.
And Codex unlocked. Storvaka. Are the Kokori Wilds to the west... They're to the far south. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I think they're pretty sure they're in the far south. Yay, everybody leveled up all of a sudden. Solas, what do you want, Solas? So Solas is the one I feel like I have the most trouble with. He just has so many abilities that I want him to have. This is ridiculous. I have all the passive abilities on ice. I could give him a couple passive abilities for electricity. Let's see, I could give him that eventually. Magic on the leg, so that unlocks magic. See, Solas is a big damage dealer. Magic. Oh, he does. He could use some more willpower. Jeez. You cheat and use level guides or auto level? I've had several people who have like helped me out and like given me some really good advice, especially for my own personal characters, really. And I just try to use that to like decide what to do for PC character or non-playable characters. Constitution, nice. Ooh. Oh, well, okay. I guess my parents just came and went, and I told everyone to say bye. Bye! You just don't know what to ever do. I know, it's... Well, and there's definitely, like, certain ways, like with Erica, like, I had no idea what I was doing, and I was just giving people abilities, and... But ever since playing Origins and Dragon Age 2, I've tried to pay more attention to, like, their stats and stuff. It's so weird to me that mages have critical damage in Inquisition when they didn't have it in Origins. And see here, you can like, you can change the tactic setting from disabled, preferred, or enabled. So I'm kind of curious if your NPCs, if your companions will actually use these abilities. Like, I do have Mind Blast actually. Okay. Well, I think there was Wall of Ice. I don't have Wall of Ice on his like available abilities, but does he use it? I think he actually does use it occasionally. But bye, Irish parishes. Bye, my parents. Bye. Bye bye. Seshu, I'm checking what you've linked. A world map! dude, I've actually been looking online for, like, a printed copy of, like an official printed copy of the Thetis map. I would freaking love that. I would buy that in a heartbeat. Come on. It's, like, taking forever. Well, I know that there are people who have made websites where you can, like, I mean, they have, like, all this really cool information inputted into the maps, and you can, like, take off layers, and, like, I don't know, like, some people have made online some very intense maps, and I need to check those out more, but they're pretty dang cool. Yeah, the Kokari Wilds are in the south, that's right. That's right. For some reason, I always think Ostagar is where the Circle Tower is. I don't know why. I just do. But then I remember that they say in one of the entries that the Krakari Wilds are in the south. So, we are... The Arbor Wilds... Well, no, this is Ferelden, right? Let me see. Hold up. So, I also have to remember that when I'm looking at the Origins map, it's only the Ferelden side. And once you get into, like, the Emerald Graves and the Empries, like, that's not where you're gonna be at. Like, that's not the Ferelden map. You know, it's in Orlais, technically. So... That's the other thing about the hero. Yeah, he's in the far, he or she, they're in the far west. And I haven't actually seen that thing. I've only heard about it, that, like, letter. But I couldn't remember if they said far east or far west. But Far west. What's over here? You know? What's past Orlais? Interesting. Well, because I'm pretty sure, I mean, Tevinter is up north, but I don't know exactly where. But I believe this is actually the biggest map that you get of Thedas so far. But I'm sure, like, one of the art books or the lore books that I have might give you a better idea of what's to the west. But there are, like, the uncharted lands that are out to the west. And then they're, like, across the Amaranthine. The Amaranthine Ocean is... Is this the Amaranthine Ocean? Or is the Amaranthine Ocean, like, way over here? Because this isn't really, like, an ocean. This looks just, you know, not... Yeah, definitely. The Kakari Wilds are south. Did you realize you can drag the spell bar at the bottom? The spell bar? Yes, yes, Kayuk, yes. You just gotta do the Dragon's Keep, right? How to make my own world state? Yeah. I've actually made a world state that I'm gonna play with Erica eventually when I do my canon playthrough with Erica. Talon, unfortunately, I started playing him, I think, when I was in the middle of Dragon Age 2 or something. I hadn't quite finished the series yet, so I couldn't make a world state. So he doesn't get the benefit of that custom world state, but that's right. If the hero was part of the West, they wouldn't be in Ferelden at all. There's High Ever. Interesting. Oh, that's right. I was doing things. Oh, Solace. You need willpower, dude. Where's willpower at? Is it in... It's probably in electricity. Nope. Not will... Okay, there's some... There's a will... There's a willpower. Jeez. There's a willpower... There's friggin' fire ability. Jeez. But I don't... I don't know what I want. Well, maybe I'll just give him this and grab these two passive abilities, and then after that I have no idea what to do. You never played Dragon Age 2, Kirk? Oh, most people haven't. Well, not most, but a lot of people haven't. I don't blame you. A lot. Sometimes people, from what I've heard, will play Dragon Age... Well, a lot of times they'll play Inquisition first, go back to Origins, and then not play 2. Or they'll play Origins, and then they just wouldn't have played 2, and then they play Inquisition. Which I can totally see why people will do that. But at the same time, Dragon Age 2 has some of the best characters, I think. Most well-written characters. Even if the graphics are trash and it feels very rushed in a lot of ways because it was. But, you know, it's just, it is what it is. I enjoyed it in many, many ways. Is it... Oh, shoot. Have that, Cassandra. Jeez. Your two is just... Two is not just bad. Two has very good redeeming moments. And throughout the entire game, it's just really interesting because I had this problem, and I had a friend with this problem, and I've known somebody about this problem, that when you play the game, you feel like you're rushing madly through it, and you don't really connect with your Hawk very much, so you have to actively slow down and try to get into their head and be like, what would Hawk think about this? What would Hawk think about this? Purple Hawk, if you play Purple Hawk, which means to take all the purple dialogue options, because they're freaking hilarious, and it makes the game just that much more awesome. It's freaking hilarious. But the romances are excellent. I can't wait to do more of them. But I was really excited to play it only because people said that the characters were amazing, and they are. So, if you still want to, if you want to at all, I would recommend it. I always recommend it. Plus, from what I've heard, Hawk was actually supposed to be one of the most important players, or one of the most important characters in the series. But because EA, they're horrible, they rushed the game horribly, and BioWare did what they could with what they had. So, but the character that they definitely got the characters written out extremely well. The caves are incredibly repetitive. But if you go into it, I think knowing what's up, then it's not, you're like, okay, this is what I have to do, you know? Yay! Let's do that too. Passive ability. Yay! I may have to go rescue my dog from himself. I love this letter. Lowlanders, if you're brave enough, Orlesians, if merchants, blah, blah, blah. I'm saying, I would read it, but it's like, it's definitely easier to appreciate it just reading it. And your lovers look supple. I can just hear my dog upstairs. This is a fool's task. Angry sketches of axes. Combat isn't that bad. It's definitely weird. I definitely felt like combat in Dragon Age 2 was... You just meant that you can see a lot more of your skills in combat, moves, spells, potions if you drag the bar, the full width of the screen. Oh! See, and I've only ever played on the Xbox, so I didn't even, because I just used the, basically you just use the wheel and on the Xbox. And you just have like an infinite wheel. Whoa! My bad. My bad. There's definitely, the combat definitely takes getting used to. I would probably not play as a warrior, to be honest, because I feel like they do the least amount of damage of everybody, which is kind of retarded, but, because they shouldn't, but they do, for whatever reason. But I enjoy, like, I liked my hawk. I had a female hawk, and she was a two-handed warrior, and I really liked it.
They know whose ground this is.
Inquisitor.
Yo!
You've need of a hunter, or you're just wondering.
Now you I like this guy. Hold,
but I'll tell you, there are none finer.
I assume you go hunting yourself.
Of course I do. Huh? Who says otherwise?
That no one.
I lead our hunts, Inquisitor. My leg aches. One eye can't see in the dark. And I bring more meat than anyone in the hold. Goat's piss, do I hunt?
I apologize. I was just curious.
Suppose you can't help Lowlander's manners.
Do you have any idea where Storvacker is gone?
All your mains are rogues? You'll have a... If you play Dragon Age 2, you will have a fantastic time.
The weather's turning. I'd not think she'd run further.
The rogue abilities in Dragon Age 2 looked awesome. Isabella was in my crew, and she was a rogue. Just do whatever Isabella's abilities are, because they're amazing. She was my highest damage dealer. She could tear apart enemies that my warrior would have been, like, just hacking at for days. Dang, that was a little bear. Aww. On the third night. Stone bear. Nice. I like it. From Stories of the Wild South, a collection of tales of the barbarian nations of Ferelden by Lady Susanna Ashwell of Ansburg. You always have to check and see who's the one writing the tales. Because it is not... Because the Avvar don't actually... It doesn't seem like they have a written language. They don't read. They're an oral tradition. So anybody who's writing down their tales, you're going to probably get... Because of translation issues as well, you're going to get a little bit of a bias or a skewed view. But freaking look at this cute little bear. It's so cute. Right, I figured... No, Larry. I figured you meant Dragon Age Origins. Sorry, I didn't specify either. Because I've actually been really curious if in Origins... Because it's a heavily PC game. I'm really curious if it will look like a PC game. Or if it'll... Because I'm gonna use a controller for sure. And I'm wondering if it'll still have controller, like... Like the thing, the wheel, or if it will actually have the bar. Because I've wondered that for Mass Effect as well, because it's a different layout for PC as opposed to a console.
Inquisitor, I'm honored by your visit. I'm Finn Coldenson. Forgive me if I don't stand to greet you properly.
You all right, buddy?
How were you injured?
A storm blew up a few months back. The worst we've seen in a while. I was helping to secure the fishing boat. Einar nearly fell in. I caught him, but the current caught me. My leg got crushed against the rocks.
Yikes!
It hasn't set properly.
You seem troubled.
Blackpool would like the bear carving.
The Gida Myrdotten prepares my father's body for sky burial.
I'm sorry.
I knew it would be soon. I just...
Cassandra, that was nice.
I'll let you rest.
Lady keep you.
And you. We'll help you out, Finn. Don't worry about it. Don't even worry about it. I don't want to do that fight thing. I don't want to do it. Blackwall and Sarah were fun to bring. I brought them out here and they were hilarious. Yo? Anybody? Nobody here? Aight. What can I buy? Ah! Oh my gosh, you can buy it! Look at that! Wow, what a freaking sexy looking knife! Jeez! Ritual Breaker. Oh, it's a mace. Whew! In the PC game, you have the bar, yeah. I can see it vaguely in my head. I think I've seen a screenshot of Origins on the PC. So I know what you're saying. I get it. Masterwork Winged Longbow. I think that's what I have right now, is I have a winged longbow. Wow. Refined Prowler Co. What's up with that? Refined? Refined? Hey, look, you can get and you can get Cole's hat! Oh, cool! And that's Vivian's hat! Ah! And that's Vivian's hat! Okay, this isn't Vivian's hat. This is Vivian's hat. No weapon wheel. Yeah, I saw a screen. I think specifically I can remember in Mass Effect. I remember seeing a screenshot, or somebody was showing me something on YouTube, like a clip they had done to show me, like, armor type or weapon types or something. And they had a bar across the bottom of the screen, and I was like, holy crap. I'm like, the differences are actually quite large. Yeah, and I have some nice gear for sale in here. Hold up. Let me save. Yeah. And I will buy that one. I'm gonna buy that one. The refined Prowler coat. See what that looks like. Wait. Okay. Gotta go over here to the crafting of the... If you don't let me craft armor, I'm gonna be so mad! Crafting weapons. Why is this just here? Why is this crafting weapons? Where is my armor crafting? Is there no armor? Okay, here we go. Nope! No, I hate that one. I hate it. They're both, okay, they both are? Does she like, oh, is it like when she like likes you? she gets a new hat, I think. Is that what it is? Oh, hey. Person, you weren't here last time. A refined battle mage coat. Let's see what the refined battle mage coat looks like for Dorian. Ah, let me out! Let me out! Dorian! 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 Wow, that is some really high level armor. Wow, it's even higher. No way! It's higher than Vestments of the Pure? Oh my gosh. But there was that one that I really liked, actually, that I ended up liking that I didn't think I would like that I did. On Dorian. And it wasn't this one. Well, I'm not gonna get that one right now. But I will try to remember that it's here. Right, Cole's hat and Assassin's hat. Assassin's hat actually does look quite different. Cole's hat is like floppy brimmed, and then the Assassin's hat is quite spiky, look, or quite stiff. But it's good to know that those things are there. There was another guy over there that we can talk to, another merchant. And I think he can kind of end up being some sort of agent for the Inquisition somehow. Hello.
Be welcome, Inquisitor. Though I fear I've time for little more than a greeting. I must prepare these souls for their greater journey. Particularly those who depart without the reverence due.
Yucky!
Their way is often hardest.
Huh?
I'm not familiar with Avvar.
Why are there skeletons just laying around? That seems pretty disrespectful.
Comes, we are given sky burials. For most, the body is laid out and prayers given. When the birds come, they carry the soul to the Lady of the Skies. The body, unneeded, is gone.
For
I love the Avvar rituals.
Such as Calden's, are chosen to return.
I love their take on the gods.
It is a rare honor. In order to return, an offering is made to Korth the Mountain Father and buried beneath the body. A piece of the soul thus remains, allowing the rest to return to this world and be reborn.
Is there a problem?
Will someone not be given proper rites?
Calden Enverson is one of the few whose soul may return. Bloodkin must make an offering to the Huntmaster who prepares it. Or so it should be. Calden's son, Finn, has failed in this duty, but then there's...
I love their clothes!
You're a guest of our hold. A gift from you cannot be refused. Even an offering for Golden. I cannot dictate the nature of a gift, but if my suggestion appeals to you...
She's trying.
The Huntmaster.
Very hard.
Golden's son is injured. It's not his fault he can't make the offering.
As disappointing as that may be, it is not my place to ignore the gods' laws on a whim. I honor them in word and spirit, Inquisitor.
Yet...
You suggested a way around tradition by letting me make the offering.
The spirits have seen Finn fail. To undo it may be to undo their will. A gift from another does not bear this weight. Calden's soul could travel easily.
Huh?
I should be off.
Lady keep you.
All right. There's a bard in there. She's cool. I like her too. Yo, guy, I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to be like that, guy. Forehead is level with his foot. I'm pretty sure you're probably supposed to be up there, or maybe right down here. But I'm pretty sure, unless you're like an Avvar god who's just decided to poke his head out of a wall, that's not what you're supposed to do. Let's go. There's so many more people here this time, too. I like it. Skald!
You're the Inquisitor.
I hear your people already sing songs of you.
Yeah.
How are you so well informed?
Oh, Helstim soaks up gossip when he goes trading. He just returned from the lowlands. I'm Fulna Hethstotten, keeper of histories, and skald to the hold.
I've never met a skald.
A skald?
Is that anything like a bard?
I suppose. Every hold has someone who sings its songs. Doesn't yours?
Look at this hold. It's so cool looking.
We keep the old songs and histories, the oaths and the legend marks.
Oh, I know. I love the way she hints not so subtly how to fix things. Yeah, no, she's determined to make it happen.
All of that except legend mark.
The skald before me was born.
Solus's bald head keeps popping in and out.
She crafted a great new tale for the hold. It pleased the spirits. After that, we called her Gulda Gildan's Song.
So they're titles.
Bald head.
Not all carry glory. My father was Heth Mule's Head.
Mule's Head.
Never let go of a quarrel.
Can you choose a legend mark for yourself?
Only if I wanted to be scorned as a child.
I love the Avvar girls' outfits. I want one of these for the winter time.
Great feats, good or ill, yet.
I'm not really sure why there's a hole in the back of the hood. I assume it would be for some sort of ventilation. But
farewell.
It seems like it wouldn't let anything in, like water or wind or anything. Unless you were facing the wrong way. But, ooh, look at this. Look at this table. Holy crap, that is so nice. Wow. That is very pretty. I really like that. And look, this is totally for the Thane and her consort. Woo-hoo. There's entrails everywhere. It's great. Kegs. It's great. I love it. Oh my gosh, look at the potatoes!
Half the traps were empty. Is someone poaching? Can't be.
Oh my gosh, is that fish? Or are those more potatoes? I think those are potatoes. No, it looked kind of like rocks. Maybe they're supposed to be fish.
Wind seems colder than it should.
Oh my gosh, they say that all the time in this place. Wind seems colder than it should. Aw, are you two like flirting? But then Dad's here and you're like, doop-de-doop-de-doo. Nothing going on here. Nothing to see. Nothing to see here. I love the auger. Oh, hey. Oh, hey, what are you doing? Are you refereeing? I think he's like refereeing. The male Avvar outfit of this looks ridiculous, but what you gonna do? The girl one, though, I love. I want one in real life so bad. Like, if anything could get me to sew something, like, I would do that. Oh, I think this guy, like, isn't here or something? Simple but artfully rendered indicates the owner of this meat shop decided to spend the day mixing out chemical potions, or more likely, alcoholic drinks. And the people should take what they like and pay him later. Are you the guy who owns this place? Because there wasn't anybody here last time, and holy crap, there are dead things everywhere. This is kind of gross. This is a little bit horrifying. There's people everywhere in here. Holy crap. Examine what? Avvar cuisine. That's right. What exactly do you have? Lurker scales. You got. Why? I like that this shop is here. I wouldn't really buy anything from it, but. Oh, hey. Free the Nug! Free the Nug! Ah! Is that okay? Am I gonna get in trouble? I'm gonna get in trouble, aren't I? Hey man, I just opened the gate. Whatever happens, happens. Hey guy. Guy, where's the guy? Ooh, people's house. They keep the alcohol or the jam. Maybe the jam, yes, we'll say jam. They keep the jam right next to their bed. Man, food is like all over the place here. Look at that freaking massive cheese wheel. Release the Nog! Yeah, I can hear it. Did you hear it? I heard it squeak.
What did I tell you? All of this from the north.
Are you following me? It's following me! Oh my gosh! Cassandra, we need to take it back to Lele Mass Effect 2 where you go to Tachanka and if you feed the Varen, it follows you everywhere. I love it! Is it following me? I don't know. I need to find that guy. The king will be pleased. I'll have to report to the Nug King and say, stranger. I bring you one of your own. Where's that guy? He has stuff I can buy from him. Are you that guy? You're not that guy. He's not in here. Where is he? That's the butcher. Leliana. I know, I'm just getting in good with Leliana. Oh, here he is.
Our guests are welcome. So long as their weapons stay sheathed.
Dude, I think I noticed this last time, but like, oh wait, are these Avvar symbols? But also, it looks like you're doing blood magic on the walls. But these might be like Avvar symbols that they use to like communicate. But that definitely looks like blood magic. That's definitely like a runic shape. And why is there a pig's head stuck on that scarecrow? That's sort of terrifying and gross. Oh, he's got look, he's got like a painter's thing. What is that called? That like, I'm not the easel, Charlotte, it's the other part.
I am sorry about your friend.
Thank you.
I knew demons and spirits were similar, but I did not know one could become the other so easily.
Not similar, Seeker. The same. The Chantry sees black and white, but nature is and always has been gray. A spirit is a purpose. A demon is that purpose perverted.
That might be true with the spirit of compassion, but what is the purpose of a hunger demon?
Survival, satiation, the pleasure of taste, of feeding. True hunger, however, is much darker. Think of all those who starve in this world. Mankind has itself to blame for the existence of demons.
Oh, buddy.
You're the one they speak about in the lowlands, aren't you?
He's got like a little handlebar mustache.
Herald of Andraste.
Many call me that.
Helmsdim Rolfson. I trade our goods outside the hold. You'll not find better this side of the mountain.
Have you traveled outside of Stonebear Hold?
Course Mountain Father provides. But press us, and we'll admit there's lowlander goods we can't craft ourselves. I sell our goods there. The old trader taught me how to read and write, and how to act in your cities.
Where does your trading take you?
Denerim and Southreach in Ferelden. Leeds and Verchet in Orlais. When the passes are clear, I take our wares to Val Royeaux.
Ooh, buddy.
Surely you can get a fair price for your goods closer than Val Royeaux.
Ah, well, that's true, but have you seen
He's a wanderlust,
My
Avvar.
My heart lies with the hold. But I'll die remembering the light on the gates of the sun.
Whoa! Well, yes.
One of the most beautiful cities in the world.
Everyone thinks I'm mad when I speak of Orlais. They believe I make half of it up. As if I could dream up those fountains and palaces.
The frilly little cakes, Solis!
Most in the hold call any city outside the mountains prideful or lowlander folly.
Right, exactly. He's not wrong. Like, it's a beautiful city. It may be treacherous, but it's a beautiful city.
Farewell.
Another time.
Can I bash here for you? That's right! This is where we get all the Avvar stuff. Ooh, buddy. Let's get the Avvar glass and the Avvar bed and... Gosh dang it. I swear you can, like, find some of this stuff. And I swear I have Avvar decor. I know I do. But I don't know. I'm just gonna buy it. Because I want it. I want it. Major upgrades. What? I swear I had the throne too. That's a bit weird. Ooh, the auger's in here. Ooh.
What did I tell you?
I like this guy.
So he arrives. Don't throng.
Yeah.
Behold, worthy ones. The man who blazes like fire and mends the air.
What is this?
It's safe. They mean no harm.
I am the Augur.
Ooh, Cassandra and Solas.
I greet you, as do our gods and the gods of our ancestors. Well, it is done. Now come, be welcome. But hear news of the North.
Woo, buddy!
Did you just introduce me to
the gods of the hold clamored to see you. I obeyed, for I'm their voice.
I love this guy. His voice is awesome.
If I didn't show you off, they'd hound me for months.
What did you mean when you said I blaze like a fire?
How do you think you appear to the gods of the Fade? To those beyond the veil, your hand burns like the Watchman's bonfire.
Well.
I haven't found a way to stop it.
You'd shun a favor from the gods. I see you've already killed one.
Ah!
Envy that grasped for your crown.
Cool! Last time I didn't do the. I did the. I think he said you muddied time in the place where the cliffs run red, is what he said last time when I chose the mages with Erica. But oh, I didn't think about that he would see it as a throwing away a favor from the gods. That's interesting.
I'd like to ask something.
Then ask.
Interesting to think that maybe Talon does kind of want to get rid of it, though. Like, he doesn't want to keep... Like, I think Erica just didn't think about it. But maybe Talon does eventually, like, want to... Like, that would be his quest, maybe. Like the hero of Ferelden's trying to find a way to cure the Blight. Maybe eventually Talon would like to cure himself of the Anchor. But don't worry, buddy, old pal. It'll happen sooner than you think.
I assume Augur is another word for mage.
I am a mage. Yet not all mages are Augurs. I give counsel to other mages and the Thane. In turn, an augur takes counsel from the gods and shares it with the
An augur is very different from a mage.
Well, known to us,
well, it's a very specialized branch of mage.
So you're an ambassador to the local spirits.
Some have wisdom for those willing to listen.
They protect the hold. They help drive.
I'm pretty sure I brought Solas with me last time, but I don't remember him chatting this much.
The gods live with us. Ignore their offerings. Offer them nothing.
I wish Dorian would say more.
I've heard enough to realize that when you say gods, you mean spirits. Why do you pray to them?
We offer to them. We don't pray like the lowlanders to a creator they think will weather all the ages.
This is key. Super key.
Do you actually think they're divine beings? Something more than magic.
The spirits watched us even before we came from the north. They shaped themselves into our gods, and we grew to love them. Their secret gift is this, Inquisitor. They reflect us as water does the sky. They show us what we wish to be. That image gives us strength. For that, we thank the gods.
I should be off.
Farewell.
I love this man. I think when I came here last, Solas had already broken up with me. And I was basically like, hey guy, you wanna get together? So do we all know what's going to cure the anchor? Yeah, I'm pretty sure everybody knows what's gonna cure the anchor at this point. Ashley's already finished Trespasser. She's just, baby Nug. What name do you have, baby? I'll call you baby. Hey baby. But yeah, she's already finished it. This is my second character too, so I basically said at the beginning of the YouTube Let's Play, I was like, this is gonna be a spoiler round. If you don't want spoilers, don't watch. Oh yeah, I gotta speak to the Huntsman. Oh crap, I gotta do that. Go back. I should actually also probably do the Dangnab hold fight. And then I have to be careful. I think there's only 6 ways to get approval up, or maybe 7. And there are 2 that I don't do it in such a way that you get hold approval. but I do it in a way that I feel comfortable with. Oh, did I go? Yeah. Oh, wait. Oh, crap. Oh, dang it. There's not invulnerability here. I know, right, Kai? How are you supposed to use your bow? Oh, don't even get me started. Of all my characters, I feel the most sad for my archer. I feel most sad for Talon. I mean, they have got to do their with great difficulty, same as me. No, man, they have got to give you some sort of prosthetic, like an elven prosthetic. Like, I guarantee you a Dalish Keeper could make you something. Like, I guarantee you Valana, if I asked Valana to make me something, she probably could. It might try to kill me occasionally, but she could make it. You know, and I guarantee you the dwarves, I guarantee you Dagna. Dagna alone could make me something.
I spoke to the woman preparing bodies for funeral.
I really want to see my Inquisitor with a prosthetic in the next game. I just want a glimpse of my prosthetic, of my Inquisitor with a prosthetic in the next game.
Woman. In that case, I'll accept an offering from the hand that gives it. Tradition says the offering's made to Korth. Only creatures who touch the god's realm will do. I'll mark where some were last spotted. It'd be an unmatched gift, Lowlander. I still pity Colden's son, though, losing his father's name.
What do you mean?
Finn failed to complete the rites. That'll see him disowned when the burial's complete. He's fatherless whether you do this or not, Inquisitor. Seeing it done will give him some peace, I imagine.
When Sarah was here, she made a big hullabaloo about that. She was not pleased. You don't want a crossbow hand? Well, you get a crossbow hand if you're really good friends with Sarah. I wasn't last time with Erica. I, for some reason, she didn't like me that much, so I didn't get to have it, which I do want, but instead of that, I also want actually something that would be a decent prosthetic, you know, that I could use.